Praise the Lord, family. Praise the Lord. I know there's some worshipers in the house tonight. Only the worshipers came on the night before Thanksgiving. I need every worshiper to jump up on your feet and give God some praise. This is a special service for you. I mean, the worshipers are in the house tonight. Come on. Every worshiper, lift your voice and give God some praise in here. Only you know what he's done for you. Only you know what he is to you. Only you know how much he means to you. Just for about 10 seconds, lift your voice and let's give God some worship in here. Hallelujah. 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 God, we give you praise. We give you praise. We give you praise, Lord God. We are so grateful to be in your house tonight. And so welcome to our pre-night of worship. Pre-Thanksgiving night of worship, everybody. Just turn to someone and tell them it's good to see you. So we have this event every year, and we're excited that you're here. I know many of you probably have some food in the oven right now, and you're ready to get back to your families, but I just think that it's appropriate that we come together before we celebrate on tomorrow and give God what he's due. Come on, let's just honor our God. Amen. Hallelujah. He's so faithful. He loves us so much. And so, of course, we can take a little time out of our busy schedules to honor him. We've got some great special guests in the house tonight. They're no strangers to us. They're friends of ours. They're partners with ours. And they're going to bless this house tonight. We've got Koinonia Choir in the building tonight. We've got Anointed Feet Dance Ministry in the house tonight. We've got Shante Atkins in the house tonight. And we've got B. Alexander McCargo and Kingdom Worship in the house tonight. We've even got the Center of Hope Worship Team in the house tonight. But the greatest thing of all, Jesus is in the house tonight. And I think that we should just give Jesus some praise tonight, church. Come on, let's give God glory. Somebody's going to leave here different tonight. Somebody's going to leave here different tonight. Turn to somebody and say, God is fighting for you. Come on, we're going to start this party right. Tell somebody, God's fighting for you. That's the first thing you need to know. When you enter into the house of worship, the first thing you need to know is that God is on your side and he's fighting for you. Come on, everybody, put your hands together in here. Lift your voice, say, let's say, God is fighting. God is fighting for us. God is on our side. He has overcome. Yes, he has overcome. We will not be shaken. We will not be moved. Jesus, you are here. He's here, y'all. What's he doing? Carrying our burdens.
Covering our shame.
He has overcome. Yes,
he has overcome.
We will not be shaken. right. How many believe that tonight? Come on, let's say it.
God is fighting for us, pushing back the darkness, lighting up the kingdom that cannot be shaken. In the name of Jesus, the enemy's defeated,
and we will shout it
loud, shout it.
Say it again, church.
God is fighting for us, pushing back the darkness, lighting up the kingdom that cannot be shaken. In the name of Jesus, the enemy's defeated,
and we will shout it out. Say it again.
God is fighting for us. Pushing back the darkness, lighting up the kingdom.
Thank you, God. Thank you that you are with us, Lord. Thank you for the reminders in our lives that allow us to really land on that, God, that you're fighting for us, that we can find just solid ground knowing your truth, God, that you're fighting on our behalf and that we've got the victory as long as we just remain in you, God. We want to remain in you. We want to talk like you. We want to look like you. We want to see through your eyes, God. We want to speak like you. We want to sound like you. Are there any worshipers in the house that just want to look like God tonight? God, we just bless you and give you thanks. We just open up our mouths and just, we receive what you've got to say through us and to us tonight, God. God, have your way all night long as each person comes to minister your word. Speak through them, Lord God. Speak your word and reassure us of what you want us to know. Let's sing this together. Say, by his stripes, we are healed. By his nail, his hands were free. By his blood, we're washed clean. Now we have the victory.
Now we have the victory.
The power of sin is broken. Cry it out.
The power of sin is broken. Jesus overcame it all.
That's what you did for us, Lord. And we're grateful for it. He has won.
He has won our freedom. Jesus has won.
Hallelujah! the provision that you provide. God, we just forget, so forgive us for forgetting. And today we remember that you have done so much for us. We look at this year, where would we have been without the Lord on our side? But God, it's been your marvelous love that has given us so much. So God, we say thank you. We thank you for our families. We thank you for our friends. We thank you for our neighbors. Lord, we thank you for so much that you do for us. You protect us. You secure us. You keep us in your protection. Not one of us can be plucked out of your safety, so thank you. And even as we think about how many people are here, our faces are different and so are our needs. And so, Lord, tonight we're not going to be anxious about anything, but the scripture says in prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, we give everything to you, Lord. It's in thanksgiving that we thank you for our provision. It's in thanksgiving that we thank you for our salvation. It's in thanksgiving that we thank you for our finances. It's in thanksgiving that we thank you for the salvation of our families. It is in thanksgiving that we just lift up all of our needs, knowing that you know about them even before we ask. So, Lord God, we say thank you. We say thank you, Lord. We say we love you, Lord. We say, Lord, whatever you want us to do, that's what we owe you. You've done so much for us, God. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And all God's people, join in with me. Just give me crazy praise. Crazy praise. Crazy praise. Crazy praise in the name of Jesus.
You may take your seats. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. God is a good God. Wow. Good evening, family. My name is Minister Rico, and on behalf of Center of Hope, Pastor Jeremy, First Lady Adrienne, and the staff, we welcome you. Welcome to Night of Worship. Amen. Now listen, if this is your first time and you're a visitor, thank you for coming. As you can see, we have pulled out everything to make sure you were accommodated. We thank you for coming to celebrate a great God with us. You could have been anywhere, in the kitchen, cooking, prepping, but God saw it fit that you would be with us this evening. We say thank you. We don't take it for granted. We don't take it lightly. So family, join with me and let's celebrate these great visitors that made it out tonight. Amen. One thing that we pride ourselves on as a church is that we are a generous church. We are a church that gives. And if you notice, to my left and to my right, we have boxes on the wall. Those boxes are specifically designed for offering. So at any given moment throughout service, please feel free to provide an offering. We're not going to hold you up. We're not going to stop you. We're not going to time you. At any given moment, please feel free to provide an offering. And for those who are savvy on the mobile, we also have a mobile app called PushPay. That's another opportunity for you to give to a ministry that is speaking to the masses. Know that your offerings, your donations helps us do what we do in the great way that we do it. Amen? Amen. Now, listen, one more thing. This is Thanksgiving, right? We are thankful, right? Okay, now this is the best time for me. So I want you to do something for me real quick. I want you to stand up. I want you to stand up. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Awesome. All right. So this is what we like to call the meet and greet. Okay, so we're going to put 90 seconds on the clock. And within those 90 seconds, I want you to go around to people that you don't know, a new face, introduce yourself, and tell them three things that you're thankful for. All right? Go. And if you're watching by live stream, we thank you. We thank you for just tuning in with us. As you can see, this is what we do. So listen, if you're on PushPay, please feel free to provide and provide a donation and an offering. We thank you for your many blessings. We thank you for you. We're praying for you and know that you're here with us in spirit. Amen.
Church, let's welcome to the stage the Koinonia Choir under the direction of Lorinda Jameson. Put your hands together.
being able to connect with the people as a worship leader really takes a lot of preparation and time behind the scenes. I think that what people don't get a chance to see is the time that we spend before God, which really is asking God for what do the people need weekly? What do they need to be encouraged with? What songs do they need to hear that's gonna give them the inspiration and connect them in worship? And I think it comes from a personal relationship with the Lord, and then hopefully that translates to the listener that what comes from the heart reaches the heart. The connection between the worship and the word, I believe it is a unique instrument in itself. I believe that I like to call it the Kobe lob. The ball is thrown in the air and the slam dunk is there. The word has power, worship has power, and when you unite those two, it's a great, great marriage. I believe that the calling to the worship is just as important as the calling to the word, because I believe God meets people in both spaces. So some people come for different reasons, but here at Center of Hope, they get it all from the worship and the word. This is us. Connection.
Praise the Lord, church. Praise the Lord. Turn to somebody and say, choose to give him praise. The choir said you got to choose to give him praise. And as worshipers, sometimes that's what we have to do, right? Sometimes it's all about swimming upstream, but we've got to choose. We've got to make the choice to give him praise. Let's bless the Lord for Koinonia Choir, everybody. Thank you, God. Thank you, God, for their anointed ministry. Well, this next guest is no stranger to us, and she needs no introduction. Everybody, Shante Atkins.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. I'm so excited to be in the house of God on tonight. I just thank God for being so awesome and so wonderful and so sweet and so kind. He's so good. Is he good to anybody else? Amen. And because he's so good to me, I decided that I was going to serve him for the rest of my life. So I'm going to sing this song. And it simply just says, I'll serve you for a lifetime, I'll serve you for a lifetime, I'll serve you for a lifetime, I will. Ain't that easy? So I'ma ask, if you don't know it, just act like you do, because we all in church, so we know how to do that, right? All right, so I'm gonna ask you, stand to your feet, and we're gonna sing this song. It's a little upbeat, so you can move around a little bit. Stand still if you want, you know, I'm a mover, so I'ma move. Is that all right? Amen, hallelujah. Hey. Hey, hey, yeah. Clap a little bit. Nobody but you, Lord, hey. Came and rescued me, tied up in bondage. Hey. It was you who set me free.
I'll serve you for life.
you could do it. Nobody but you could do it. Can we sing it one more time? I'll serve you for a lifetime, Lord, 'cause you went all the way to the cross just for me, Lord. And you shed your blood. Because he laid down his life, we gonna lay down our life for him. And whatever you say, Lord, we'll say. Whatever you tell us to do, Lord, we'll do. And we bless and honor and glorify your name. Hallelujah. 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 Is he not good? Is he not awesome? Is he not worth it? Hallelujah. I'll serve you for a lifetime, I will. So since we're serving the Lord for a lifetime, we got to follow him everywhere he go. And we got to know his voice, and we got to listen to his voice. Amen? Amen? Amen. So this song talks about following the Lord Jesus. Are we going to follow the Lord? Wherever he tells us to go, we're going to go. Amen? Yeah. Amen. Mm-hmm. Oh, oh, oh. La, la. Love me like no other. I place no one above you, 'cause you're all I need, all I want. And when I'm feeling lost and need a little direction, your voice guides me. Wherever you lead, I will follow. I will follow everywhere you lead. Wherever you lead, everywhere you lead. La, 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 ooh, la. Oh, la, 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 la. Wherever you are, that's where I want to be. I will everywhere you lead. In a quiet place or on a crowded street, Lord, I will follow everywhere you lead. Singing in front of millions, or it's just you and me, Lord, I will follow everywhere you lead. Wherever you lead, hey, yeah, yeah. Where he leads me, I will follow. I'm gonna follow everywhere he leads. Sing it one more time. Where he leads me, I will follow. Where he leads me, I will follow. Where he leads me, I will follow. I'm gonna follow everywhere. You leave.
for the Holy Spirit.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And I'm so grateful that Jesus didn't leave us here comfortless, but he said he would send us a comforter. And then he said that he would allow his Holy Spirit to dwell in us as his temples. I don't know about you, but I'm grateful that the Lord even allowed us to be privileged enough to house the Holy Spirit within us. The Holy Spirit dwells within us and is so precious and he's so sweet and so kind. And so I'm going to sing a little bit about the Holy Spirit. Is that all right? If you guys have the Holy Spirit dwelling on the inside of you, I'm going to ask that you stand up on your feet again, if that's all right. And you just begin to thank God for his Holy Spirit. Thank God that the Holy Spirit brings you comfort. Thank God that the Holy Spirit produces fruit in you. Thank God that the Holy Spirit helps you to love. Thank God that the Holy Spirit heals your body. Thank God that the Holy Spirit gives you joy. We bless you. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. You are welcome here. Oh, oh, you're welcome here. Oh, yes, you are.
Yeah.
of us. Oh, and our hearts, oh God, are full of your presence, Lord. Your presence, Lord. Oh, Lord. Your precious Holy Spirit, Lord. I'm grateful for your presence, Lord. I'm grateful for your presence, Lord. There's healing in the place because of your presence. Deliverance in the place because of your presence. There's joy in this place because of your presence. There's love in this place because of your presence. There's happiness in this place because of your presence. We're all here tonight because of your presence. And we thank you, Lord. 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 We thank you, Lord, for being so good. We thank you, Lord, for being so kind. We thank you, Lord, for being so sweet. We thank you, Lord, you're a friend of mine. We thank you, Lord, for being so good. We thank you, Lord, for being so kind. We thank you, Lord, because you are a friend of mine. I love your presence. Oh, I love your presence. So grateful for your presence. So privileged to have your presence dwelling on the inside. Oh. And just this other song I want to just sing, it says, thank you, Lord. Oh, thank you, Lord. Oh, thank you, my Lord. I just want to thank you, Lord. Can we sing that one time, just one more time together? Say, thank you, Lord.
Worshippers, just lift your hands and give God glory right there. The atmosphere is right. The atmosphere is right. Come on. We don't ever want to rush past moments like this. Just lift your hands and right here in this presence, just as we're preparing for anointed feet to take their place, just for a couple of seconds, talk to the Lord in your own way. We're never going to rush past what he's doing. And so right here, just take your time and talk to the Lord. We're just going to get anointed feet in place, and they're going to take their place. And but just that's right. The atmosphere is right. So just lift your voice in here. Every grateful heart, every grateful heart. If you're grateful for the Holy Spirit and you're thankful because you know what he's done for you and you know what it means. You know what it means. When no one else was there, you know what it means. You know what that feels like. You know what it felt like when you didn't have anybody and you didn't have anywhere to go to. You know what it feels like when you were all alone. You know that feeling. You know what it feels like when you were all by yourself and you were talking to the Father and you didn't even know how to get those words out. You know what that feels like. And there was that sweet voice of the Holy Spirit saying, I am with you and I got you. That's why you're here tonight. That's why you're here tonight. You're here to give him thanks tonight. That's why you're here tonight. You didn't have to be here tonight. That's why you're here. Because there's something on the inside of you that just wants to say, God, thank you. I don't know how to say it with all the eloquent words. What I do know how to say is thank you. And so, God, we just thank you for moments like this where we can come together and just worship you and rest right here in your presence. And we thank you. We just want to be good stewards of what you've given to us. And we want to be obedient when you move amongst us. So we thank you and we honor you. Now continue to have your way. Holy Spirit, we give you thanks in Jesus' name.
another dimension, oh God, by your spirit and by your glory. Another place in Him. We're in another place in Him. We're in another place in Him. Another place in Him.
Say, we're in another place in Him.
Say,
we're in another place in Him.
Ooh.
Another place.
We're in
another place.
Another place.
We're in another place.
Ooh.
Another place.
Another place.
Another place.
Ooh. Another place.
We're in another place.
To another realm in your glory.
Another place.
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 Prayer in this place, greater consecration in this place. Oh, yeah, 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 yeah,
Fresh wind. Fresh wind.
Compelling stories for us is a way for us to share the essence of life. So from the dawn of time until now, families, friends, any key relationships use stories to convey what's important and what's central to their living. So when you think about Jesus, you think about someone who taught by storytelling. He used the medium of storytelling to convey an incredible truth that ultimately ends with the group he's talking to realizing that the way we're to look at someone who traditionally may be our enemy is actually someone who we are to go to the ends of the earth for. And so I think one of the most powerful tools in storytelling is getting people to understand the power of their story. Again, when we come into the traditional learning environments, we have instances where we're learning from a pastor or a teacher or a facilitator, whatever the case may be, and we tend to underestimate just how much our own stories are impactful. And so as we grow and challenge our members and attenders to voice their particular story, I think more and more people are coming to grips with the power that their own personal story shares, the encouragement that comes from it, and they begin to understand that their story matters as well. It's not just who's saying whatever from the front of the room, but it's also empowering them to understand that what's going on in your life matters. You're conveying your story and how you made it through whatever situation you're going through speaks to people, and it matters incredibly. So we're getting better at it, but it's something that I think most of us aren't all that comfortable with getting in front of cameras. But the more we're finding creative ways to capture the story and share the story, people are understanding that the things that I'm going through are for a reason, and God can actually use them to get breakthrough in other individuals' lives. This is us. Invite.
Prayerfully tonight, God is speaking to you. We hope that you're receiving from the Lord. Even as Anointed Feet was up and ministering, the Bible says to come before the Lord with singing, with dancing. And he said, David said, that I danced before the Lord with all my might. And as they danced, things were happening beyond what you could see and beyond what we know. The word of God is true. The word of God has power. It's beyond our emotions. It's beyond a feeling. And so hopefully someone will leave here tonight with an answer that they've been looking for to a question that they've had. Someone will go home and things will be different. Hopefully you came expecting, and God will meet you in this place tonight. And it's not over. We have one more guest that God's going to speak through tonight, and that is none other than B. Alexander McCargo in Kingdom Worship. Get ready, y'all.
The name of Jesus lifted high.
And it's
in the name of next part with us. Revival fires falling down, falling down, falling down. Revival fires falling down in this place. You said now.
Revival fire falling down, falling down, falling down. Revival fire falling down.
But I'm thankful all year long. You know, I know we often say it as a cliche. We say God has been good to me.
My God.
I am a poster child of that God has been good to me. Yeah. Amen. You know, I wrote a song a few years ago. It's amazing how you go through stuff and God give you songs to help you through it. So you know, over the years I've been through a lot, but God has remained faithful. Yeah. I don't know about anybody else who's survive some things, and you know God has been faithful. You know what I mean? He has been faithful. He's been faithful to me. Back, I was like, a few years ago, my son was murdered. Then, you know, had to forgive the man who killed my child. You know what I mean? That's like you got to forgive people that did stuff to you. You know, we sending people to hell for homosexuality and fornication and adultery, but you won't forgive folk, you go to hell too. Same thing. But that's a whole nother situation. You know, God has kept me through times when I was supposed to lose my mind, you know what I mean? Survive divorce. I was in the hospital at the beginning of this year. They thought I had cancer of the throat. You know, went to the hospital, thought I just had a sore throat, and I had a mass growing on the side of my esophagus. And they said they needed to do a biopsy, asked me if I had cancer in my family. I said, no, we good, my family's good. We lived like 96 years old, just buried my grandmother, she was 82. So it's like, we live a long time. We didn't have any history of stuff like that. But they said, it looks like you have cancer. I said, but my God is a healer. So that next morning, they set me up to do a biopsy. And the doctors came in the room and they did this thing. They put this thing down my nose and they thought they numbed it, but they didn't. So I was, you know, and they stuck it all down my nose, but the doctor had another doctor in the room. They said, look, it's shrinking. And I said it above a whisper. I said, you don't know the God that I serve. Huh? So I know God to be a healer. Once was there, is no longer there. And then even after I came out of the hospital, you know how the devil plays tricks with your mind when you ride down the street and you can't sing, but that's your money maker. That's how you give God glory, and you can't open up your mouth and sing. All you're doing is you go like this, and I'm like, yo, the devil's telling you, you're never gonna sing again. And it actually seems like it's real, because you're moved by what you feel and what you see. But faith is the substance of. So I'm retarded enough to believe in a God that can heal bodies. He healed my body. So my faith is not in man. My faith is in God. I wrote a song about it. You want to hear it? Here it go. Who can stand against me when the Lord is with me? 'Cause my faith is in you. Victory belongs to him. 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 Lift your hands in this place. Look, hold on for a second. Don't do that church stuff. Do that relationship stuff. Because when a child stands before his parents, it doesn't stand like this. When a child stands before his parents, it does like this. It's a sign of desperation. Basically saying to God, God, either take me out of this or strengthen me where I am. I'm talking to folk that's been through some stuff. I'm talking to folk that had to survive gossip and rumors and lies and still love people. You know what I mean? I'm talking to real folk. You know what I mean?
As we bow down.
clap your hands, lift your hands. And as you lift your hands, lift up your voice. Come on, lift your voice. This is a house of worship, so let's fill the house of worship with worship. Praise the name of Jesus. Praise the name of Jesus. He's my rock and he's my fortress and he's my deliverer. In him will I trust. Lift your hands and say, praise the name of Jesus.
Come on, you can do better than that. Come on, let's bless the Lord on this evening. Come on, as we stand to our feet and prepare to go home. Hasn't the Lord met us here on this evening? In times like these, we need to understand the power of just having a grateful heart. And we are so grateful for some of our friends coming in with night. The Koinonia Choir. Come on, let's put our hands together for Koinonia Choir blessing us, taking us right where we needed to go. And we have to praise God for Sister Shantae Atkins and her wonderful ministry, amen. Outstanding. And then, I don't know about you, but every time we see anointed feet, it just gets better and better and better. Come on, let's show some love to anointed feet as they minister tonight. Of course, B. McCargill and Kingdom Worship, it was just incredible. Come on, let's put our hands together for them. Last, of course, but not least, our own praise and worship team, the Center of Hope worship team, Minister Kurt Likes and our team, amen. I know you got stuff cooking that you got to get back to, and you're thinking about tomorrow and everything going to be all right, but this is just a moment when you stop and think about all the other places you could be right now, in the hospital, in the convalescent home, in jail or in the grave. I think this is a good spot to just say thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 And for our home folks, we want to remind you not to eat too much on Thanksgiving because we have a date with doing some service on one day, amen. And so don't forget to meet us here on Saturday morning, bright and early at 9 or 9:30, is it? 9:30, there we go. Right here, ready to go. Amen? Amen. You gonna be ready? That's what I'm talking about. Save a little room. You're gonna have to work off all that you eat. So come on Saturday morning, we'll put in work together. Amen? And then we talked a little bit earlier about giving. And part of coming into the house of worship, we often say that you haven't completed worship until you give an offering. And so Minister Rico let us know that we don't walk around or anything like that, but there are boxes all throughout, or the PushPay app. We encourage your partnership in helping us to continue to take the ministry around the world. Amen? So make sure you give before you leave on this evening. Amen? Come on, just touch somebody right near you. Touch somebody right near you. Get someone right near you. Just make a connection right near you. That's all right. And just begin to contemplate. We're in November. 2017 is almost done. And how good has God been from January all the way through to this point? Somebody needs to say hallelujah. Come on, just write to yourself right now. Hallelujah. Bless your name, Lord. We glorify you. We magnify you. And so, Lord, we say hallelujah to your name for bringing us through this year. to this point, to this moment, when we can touch our neighbor. We're holding a miracle. Lord, we're holding a powerful story of your delivering power. Your word says to give thanks in all circumstances. Lord, we bring some situations and some circumstances to bear on tonight. And we honor you for just being the God that sees and knows and watches over us. And so, Lord, we say thank you. We say hallelujah. We bless your holy name for just being that kind of God. Go with us from this place. Bring us back at the appointed time, and we'll be careful to give your name all the glory, all the honor it so richly deserves. In your blessed son, Jesus' name, let everyone say amen and amen. Make sure you hug somebody before you go home. God bless you all. Happy Thanksgiving from the Center of Hope family to yours.